Quentin Post will jump for the Eagles against another Quentin. Melora Brown for the Citadel. Post taps it a second time, getting it back to McLaughlin. And both teams still trying to find the rhythm a little bit in this one. And that will certainly help. Nice job by Hand, hanging and scoring. Now Boston College on the move.
Tremendous defense again from Quentin Post. He has the floor to the ceiling, and he stayed straight up even though he left his feet and just kind of ran into his chest and fell down.
Zackery this time gives it up to McLaughlin, and that's tipped home. I believe that'll be McLaughlin getting credit for the basket. Aligbe was also in there. Mighty appeared in 16 games last year during his freshman campaign. This is Harris, ties it at 58.
As he backpedaled down the court, starting to feel it a little bit, and here he comes again.
Yep. Harris, steal, score, timeout, the Citadel.
Again, there just wasn't a lot of rhythm on that possession. It was iso ball and then shoot a three contested.
Zackery with the inside hand after the blow by. What a big time move.
Really take a step forward with the bucket.
And now that situation you were talking about with five team fouls on each side. A lot of situational basketball to be played here. McLaughlin lays it in. Davis takes a three. Off the heel of the rim. Long rebound. Moore gets to it. Saves it to Morgan for three. That's good.
And get another look at it right here. He just beats the defender McLaughlin to the basketball. Tips it out, fortunately, to his teammate Morgan, who laces it up.
Zackery misses the front end of a one-on-one. Melora Brown has to race it up the floor. Not enough time, though. Three at the buzzer. Doesn't go for Roberts. It would have made the difference one instead of four. Boston College escapes McAllister Fieldhouse with a 75-71 victory.